The Sims recently revealed in a leak that kits were coming, and they became available for purchase today. Kits are a new type of DLC, and your opinion of them will likely be colored by their price tag. They're $5. Some of us hoped this was going to be $2 or $3 because for at least two of them, that's what they appear to be worth. On the other hand, they could charge $10 for vacuuming and some of us would buy it anyway while cursing about how it should be in the base game. Is there a value here? Well, maybe. One of them is possibly worth considering, but let's ask why? Why? I saw EA's justification to the public for why these exist, and based on the comments I've seen, they do need to explain themselves. Their explanation is that they will serve a few purposes. One, they will help stop content droughts in between packs. Second, they allow them to explore ideas they couldn't otherwise. And the tight focus is meant to let players get things they want without paying for things they wouldn't want. And a fourth reason that I'll throw in is these require minimal effort and will create a lot of value for EA shareholders. Corporate money printer go brrrr. While they did release three today, they said in the future these will release one at a time, and to that I say thank God. Because I know it's literally the only one you care to hear me talk about, let's look at Bust the Dust. Because I like you guys, we will only say three sentences about the other two kits. Bust the Dust has zero chaos offerings. It's all about a new gameplay mechanic. Installing this pack will make your Sims' floors and counters get nasty. Dust gradually accumulates on floors and furniture over time, and that takes a few days. The more Sims and pets you have, the quicker the floors will get dirty. Handheld and upright vacuums are both available to help speed up cleaning, though you can do it only with base game interactions if you don't own them. Anywhere you click, you can do a check dust level to see how dirty things are. It goes from pristine to so nasty it actually embarrasses your Sim if they have someone over. Dust bunnies will actually spawn at the worst levels. Dust bunnies generate less dust if you're friendly to them, and you can even ask them to search for collectibles. The better the relationship, the better they'll behave. If they can get happy enough, you can befriend a dust bunny. You can only befriend three, but if you do befriend them, they'll actually stay in the house even when it's pristine. Filth fiends are much more mean. The higher their mischief level, the meaner they get. They'll make your house dirty faster. You can vacuum the filth fiends up, and you might want to because they can spontaneously combust. This is very much a Sims idea, and I love that they included this. You probably don't want to vacuum up water or pet droppings, but I'm not sure what happens yet. You can upgrade vacuums to never fill, make them self-charging so that they work off the grid, and make them less likely to break. This kit actually has two aspirations, proving they are capable of doing this even on such minimal packs, which makes packs like Get to Work inexcusable. Oh my gosh, you can also disable dust in the game options, once again proving it is possible to expand options like we wish they would. As for those aspirations, Perfectly Pristine is an aspiration to do a lot of cleaning. You'll get the Perfectly Pristine trait that gives you the ability to power clean and power vacuum, gain fun while cleaning, and do all cleaning faster. Fabulously Filthy is the other aspiration. This is one that is all about misbehavior. Sims who take this will want to wallow in filth, leave out food, not do the dishes, skip chores, and explore how low their standards can go. At some point, the Sim will need to deliberately cause filth. They'll get a reward trait that gives them faster skill gains when in a filthy environment. This is honestly the most fun reward they've put in for a while, and I miss this type of creativity. Kids can use hand dusters, and with parenthood, it will improve their character values. Overall, it sounds like they did good at tying in this kit's gameplay additions to other packs, which is what you should expect for $5 for a dust system. You can also dust kids. Dusting someone meant something else at some point, and I don't mean that kind of dusting. Next up is Country Kitchen. This one has absolutely no gameplay and is effectively a styled room kit that lets you make an old-fashioned kitchen with some decorations to match that. It does seem to have a good amount of swatches for the various objects, but it's boring to talk about, so we won't do that any longer than we have to. What do you know? Throwback Fit Kit isn't really worth talking about either. It's 90s athletic leisure wear. You can look like you're going to the gym 30 years ago. There are like 20 pieces of clothing. Cool if you want that, but boring as hell to talk about. My personal opinion is that they are either going to run Sims 4 into the ground, or this is a moment in between where they're getting rid of assets they can throw together while waiting on 5 to finish. I hope to God they actually do finish before they release it this time. My videos are under half the length of most Sims channels on similar topics, but YouTube doesn't like it when I do that. Toss me a like to help me reach a few more people, and thank you for watching.